even now, says the Lord, return to me with your whole heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your hearts, not your garments, and return to the Lord your God. For gracious and merciful is he, slow to anger, rich in kindness, and relenting in punishment. Perhaps he will again relent and leave kindness and love, offerings and libations for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Proclaim a fast. Call an assembly. Gather the people. Notify the congregation. Assemble the elders. Gather the children and the infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom quit his room and the bride her chamber. Between the porch and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep and say, spare, O Lord, your people, and make not your heritage a reproach with the nations ruling over them. Why should they say among the peoples, where is their God? Then the Lord was stirred to concern for his land and took pity on his people. The word of the Lord.
neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you. The Gospel of the Lord. Sort of there's a rift joint forming. You've got to do something about that. You can't just let it ride, you know? And I think Lent is a little bit like that. And Jesus gives us in the gospel today three drills, three tools that we should be using to help that. Now, of course, our ultimate goal is to go home to heaven, right? And to become the sort of person that is the appropriate place for us to be. That's the ultimate goal. But then in the shorter term, relationships being what they are, we need to try to come closer to God and get kind of serious about that, you know, and put some discipline into our lives, like we did for that practice. So three tools. Fasting. The Old Testament people fasted. We heard that in the first reading today. In fact, most religions of the world, even the natural ones, use some sort of fasting. It's been going on for thousands of years. Native American spirituality. I'm from South Dakota, so I got to know something about that. You know what they do before they go into the sweat lodge? A lot of fasting. So people over the centuries have figured out that this practice has a use. And it's not just being mean to yourself. It puts you in a different mindset. It makes you discipline yourself. It makes you say to yourself, you know. And that's a valuable thing to be able to do, right? Because you can't have everything you want in life. And the things that you do want, you got to work for. So if there's no discipline in your life, that's just not going to happen. So, and in the spiritual life as well, saying no to yourself. And finding things to fast from. What is it in your life that you do, that you may enjoy, that maybe isn't so good for you? Like, maybe it's too much TV. If you're a smoker, maybe you could try fasting from cigarettes on Fridays during Lent. See how that goes. Little step to the longer goal. Maybe you're a person that has a bit of a potty mouth, and maybe you should fast from that during the, you know, consciousness. Lots of different things that we can figure out. You know, if I didn't have as much of that in my life as I do now, it would make me a better person. Maybe you should try that. Find something to fast from. So fasting, and then almsgiving. Of course, we associate that with the giving of some of our resources to help others, usually in the form of money, but not always. What can you give to the world that would make it better for everyone around you? Just as an example, you have a hard day at work. You come home. You just want to sit in your easy chair, have a beer, kick off your shoes, and just mindlessly watch some TV. Because it's been a bad day. But your spouse has lost her father or something like that. You need at that point to be about attending to her. And she's going to be really sad, you know, or maybe something happened that day and she just needs to talk and get it off her chest. You can choose to make it your priority that day to sit down as tired as you are and listen. That is such a gift to give other people. You know, I'm one of these people that I'm very goal driven, and when I am, get out of my way because I walk faster and, you know, I forget certain things because I'm focused on this one thing. When I was putting on my vestments for Mass, I realized that I forgot that the last Mass I wore green. And I'm supposed to wear purple. Because I got to do three masses today. Because I got fast today. Didn't have breakfast, you know. All those things. That the world is kind of like that. We're encouraged to be that busy. So, when someone comes across your path that really could use your time, where you're willing to sit down with this person, look them in the eye, and just let them start unloading. What a gift that is to people sometimes. I just noticed that as a priest. I've had, I'm a good listener, people tell me, and I've had people sit down and just unload for like 2 hours. And by the end, you can see there's some sort of weight lifted from their shoulders. They can finally say this stuff. What if you were to give a little gift like that to the world, to somebody that could really use it? Your spouse first, right? Okay, so almsgiving. Giving something to the world from your resources to make it a better place as a religious practice within us. And then finally, Jesus talks today about prayer. Prayer is simply conversation with God. And like I said, in your own marriages, in your friendships, things fall apart sometimes. You've got to figure out how to reverse that. So, how's your prayer life doing? Are you setting aside some time on a daily basis to just sit down with God and have some sort of conversation? Because if that's kind of fallen by the wayside, that's what this season is for you to reverse that situation. Maybe you go off and you take a retreat. Go to a retreat house. You're there for a few days. You go to Mass every day. You have a spiritual director who talks to you about what's going on in your spiritual life. A lot of people do a little retreat like that during Lent. And there's all kinds of ways to pray. You can pray in your own words while you're hiking. You know, you can purposely go outside, go take a walk to the beautiful place that you live, and dedicate that time to talking to God. That's one way. Are you a rosary sayer? Maybe that would be good. Some people like praying with books or the scriptures. If that's what really seems to work for you, do it. In the Catholic tradition, we have meditation, we have the liturgy, the hours. There's just so many different ways that we can communicate with God. So, if you come to that place where you haven't been doing that, go ahead. These are our tools. These are the tools that Jesus is talking about to come closer to God. And of course, coming closer to God and coming closer to other people go hand in hand, right? Someone once asked Jesus, what's the most important commandment? And he said, well, I'm not going to choose one. I'm going to splice two together. You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and strength, and your neighbor as yourself. So, the things that you do in your almsgiving, like maybe you figure out, hey, could the school use someone for tutoring? Something like that. What about the senior center? Maybe they need some volunteers. Or, you know, whatever it is. And in that process, you are connecting with people. And in doing so, spreading your natural cheer that you have, you're making the world a little better place. So what is it in your life that needs to change? And Jesus gives us these three areas. You can probably think of more. But the end goal is to come closer to God and to your fellow human being. And that's what Lent is about. Let us stand. Assured that God responds to us with grace and mercy, we offer our prayers for all those in need.
Turn back to God with our whole heart. Let us pray.
Take pity on us, sinners, as we return to you with our whole heart. We ask this in all the prayers we offer, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that He be pleased to bless with the abundance of His grace these ashes, which we will put on our heads in penitence. O God, who are moved by acts of humility and respond with forgiveness to works of penance, lend your merciful ear to our prayers, and in your kindness pour out the grace of your blessing on your servants who are marked with these ashes, that as they follow the Lenten observances, they may be worthy to come with minds made pure to celebrate the Paschal mystery of your Son, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your God and Father. As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we entreat you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity you may turn away from harmful pleasures and cleanse from our sins, may we worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Hear the thoughts of the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord and Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels as with one voice of praise.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Salvator, Dei Sucere et Terra, Gloria Tua, Hosanna in excelsis, Benedictus, qui venit in nomine
with the blessed apostles and all the saints, throughout the ages, we remain errant to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will.
Please join us in the new song, number 660, the Servant Song.
In the sacrament we have received, sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy through Christ our Lord. So, Friday is not just Fridays of Lent, but I come here to say Mass at noon. And that would be, if you're not a daily Mass goer, maybe that would be one more opportunity for you to come and pray. And additionally, during the Lenten season, we also do the Stations of the Cross as part of it. So there is one more opportunity for you to pray. And of course, when I come up on Fridays, I also hear confessions. Lent is a great time to go to confession. Avail yourself. I usually get here around 10:30, 10:45, and leave 2:30, depending on what's going on. So, I just want to make sure you know about that. The Lord be with you.